This is Ellie Tieni, matriarch of the Tieni family. While her life of philanthropy and hospitality has sown an evergreen meadow of beneficence, her legacy rests on the greatest culinary contribution to her own social circle, the chicken cutlet.
I've been blessed to have been able to partake in chicken cutlets for, I would guess now, over 50 some odd years.
Cutlets seem to find a way into every aspect of life, into every event.
They're ubiquitous in my family. They're always there somewhere.
They're good. They're really fucking good.
The convenient bag of cutlets that you can take on a picnic, a road trip.
Alimony hearing.
A typical Italian chicken cutlet, or chicken cotoletta, is a halved chicken breast pounded thin, coated in breadcrumb, and pan-fried. In true form of her social hospitality, Ellie Tieni's variation converts chicken cotoletta to party size, foregoing the pounded butterfly and opting for a nugget-adjacent format, a technique made possible by using partially frozen chicken breasts.
It's not totally defrosted, they're partially frozen. They're easier to slice thin. You want a very thin egg consistency. You really want to whip them. This is just a mixture of whole wheat and plain. The Parmesan cheese could be Parmesan, could be Pecorino Romano, could be any combination of it. And you need a lot of it. You want to give it that cheese flavor. I used to do this with a fork, this assembly line. But it's so much easier with your hands, so just make sure you wash your hands. This hand is always in the flour and stays dry, and then this hand has the egg on it. So it's just like a constant assembly line.
Her hands ebb and flow gracefully like those of an orchestral conductor, both organic and mechanical, in and out of each of the three bowls. This third bowl, a mixture of two different types of breadcrumbs, of wildly differing textures and sizes, likely holds the key to the signature Tieni cutlet. In my own fruitless efforts to recreate this dish in the past, this previously unknown factor was the unseen impediment. Thus, documentation of this process became critical when, after one pivotal event, the cutlet's eternal lineage was put perilously at risk.
One day we were at our home in which they were hosting a family get together.
I think it was around 2013 and I, didn't have a personality really.
And Ben decided that he was going to announce his newly decided lifestyle to his family.
I think I went vegan because it was the easiest way to get a brand really quick. Ever since, it's been a slow climb. I think I'm at, 40 followers on Pinterest, so.
They were not happy. And that's the day, to me, the cutlet died.
It was a proverbial slap in the face to my entire history.
Something needs to be done to preserve that legacy, I can tell you that much.
Most of the cooking done in my family is done by just passing it along and having people see how you make it. But Ellie is very fastidious when it comes to details about recipes. So I'm sure she might have this written down somewhere. Of course, she doesn't need the instructions any longer, but I'm sure she'd be happy to pass them on.
You want to make sure you prep your frying pan. You want to put it on like medium heat. And it's canola oil. I think a newer cook should use a longer tongue.
She's starting to sound like Bob Ross, huh?
The happy little cutlets dancing in the frying pan. So you got a nice golden color, and they're ready to come off. You want to lay them upright on their sides so that the oil drains. You're not just sitting them in a pool of oil. They're remaining crispy. You can definitely put them on an oven-proof dish and place them in the oven at like maybe 200 or so, just on a keep warm, and then serve them to your guests.
Today's chicken cutlets are served among a spread of fruits, snacks, spreads, dips, and pasta fagioli.
Oh, this is yummy.
Tomorrow's cutlets are rationed into gallon-sized Ziploc bags and bestowed upon the younger, hungrier, more beggared guests.
Mom!
I was gonna suggest you go to the dollar store.
Mom!
So perfect a around your neck like that.
Yeah, I'm surprised it fits. What kind of baby's got a neck that big?
I thought I would need like some string or something.
We now live in a better world than that of the past, be it solely for the fact that the recipe for Ellie Tieni's chicken cutlets is now public.